In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent. A beautiful scene of dusk depicts a sweet picture of the universe. And when the sun sets, calmness and stillness engulfs the loud voices of the day. I often see the birds returning back to their nests. These tiny creatures, lacking the faculty of reasoning and speech, believe that the best place ever found in the world is home. No matter how far we are from our homes, its necessity never diminishes. And Mr. President, respectable teachers, and dear fellows, that's the very first reason why I love Pakistan. Pakistan's creation was no doubt the finest hour of our history. Its creation speaks its dignity. History teaches us that how much cherished the dream of Pakistan was and how seriously our forefathers fought for it. Believe me or not, the most significant reason of loving Pakistan is independence movement itself. Just imagine some 100 years back, the books of history are filled with the nasty and gory tales of Hindu mindset and British atrocities. All this reminds me the brutality of Indians in Kashmir, NATO forces of Afghanistan, Israeli aggression in Palestine, and dear friends, I'm afraid of the existence in such worsened conditions. I know very well, Mr. President, that the shackles of slavery snatch all such creative facilities, and the beautiful world, a heaven to breathe in, turns into hell without freedom. By the grace of Allah, my country, my love, my homeland offers me to enjoy the open air of independence. Being a student, I'll surface the pages of history to know about the grand sacrifices of my forefathers. And as a humble token, I express my gratitude to all of them by proudly announcing in public that Pakistan, I love you. Dear fellows, I know you might wonder that how can I feel proud of saying all this when I clearly know that today we are standing at the worst place of history, where we are leveled as a nation of extremists, where David Cameron shamelessly termed Pakistan as an exporter of terrorism, where even mosques and mamborgas are not safe, where a cricket team, instead of playing for the name and honor of the country, indulges into match fixing and sport fixing, where courts themselves cry for injustice. How can one feel proud of being a part of all this? But, Mr. President, here I recall and quote John Kennedy of United States of America, who once said, "Ask not what America has given to you, ask what you have done for America." Dear fellows, this gory, gloomy and dark picture of my motherland never reduces my love for it. It further increases with new spirit and zeal. I feel great pride by my nation because despite of all this, it stands united. I love Pak Army for its unprecedented services in country's defense as well as during the disasters. Mr. President, I have millions of reasons to prove that why I love